Hi everyone and welcome. In this review note, we are going to configure an iSCSI software adapter on ESXi. I've already logged into vCenter. I've selected one of my hosts. Go into configure, storage adapters. I'm going to add a storage adapter. You have a choice of either iSCSI or FCOE. iSCSI is the one that we want. And that's basically all I have to do. The adapter is now added in. There are a couple of things we need to do to configure this so that we can consume iSCSI storage. I'm going to select the adapter. One thing I want to do is edit the name so that the IQN is going to match what was set up on the server, which was done in a previous video. What I need to do with that is get rid of this random bit off the end. If you are setting up initiators to go to multiple targets, you can do that, but we only have one initiator and therefore we will make sure that the name matches. The other thing that I have to configure on the adapter itself is the authentication. The server or the iSCSI target was configured to use CHAP. If I edit inside authentication, what I'm going to choose is unidirectional CHAP, meaning that we're going to authenticate to the server. I can choose bidirectional, where the server authenticates us and we authenticate the server. We can also allow configuration to negotiate and authenticate if the target's going to require it. In our case, we're just going to say we're going to use this, put in the username. That has to match what was configured on the target. Same with the password. And we'll OK for that. A couple of other things we have to configure before this is actually going to work. Network port binding. We have to select the network port or the kernel port, if you wish, that is going to be bound to the adapter. I'll add in the iSCSI adapter and say OK. And that now shows up. Last thing we need to do is tell the adapter where to go and look for targets. I'm going to specify I want to go out and hit my iSCSI target. The port for iSCSI is 3260. We did not do anything to customize that. And that is basically all we need to do to configure our iSCSI adapter. You'll notice a message recommending that we rescan the adapter to go and see what storage is available. I'll do that now. And once that scan is complete, we can see on the adapter that we have one target, one device, and one path. And I can always select the paths to see what I'm going to be able to acquire. And here is the target that I'm now consuming. Our target was configured on Windows Server. You can tell by the name that this is from Microsoft and then a bunch of information after that that's going to uniquely identify that target. So all we have to do to configure iSCSI initiators on vSphere. That's a wrap for the video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.